आका मैं लब के ले आवां कितों सोना तेरे नाल दा मैं लब के ले आवां कितों सोना तेरे नाल दा दुनिया ते आया कोई तेरी ना मिसाल दा मके रहन वालिया मदीने आण वालिया ओ ठोडे खाण वालिया नो असीने लाण वालिया मके रहन वालिया मदीने आण वालिया ओ ठोडे खाण वालिया नो तुसी ने लाण वालिया आका तेरे बिना डिगिया नू तेरे बिना डिगिया नू कोई ना संभालदा दुनिया ते आया कोई तेरी ना मिसालदा चेहरा तेरा नूर वंडे सारी कायनात नू ओ रब वी दरूद भेजे तेरी पाक जात नू मुख तेरा नूर वंडे सारी कायनात नू रब वी दरूद भेजे तेरी पाक जात नू हर पासे चर्चा हर पासे ओ चर्चा तेरे हुस्नो जमाल दा मैं लब के ले आवां कितों सोना तेरे नाल दा दुनिया ते आया कोई तेरे ना मिसाल दा तेरियां ते सिफतां दा कोई भी हिसाब नहीं ओ तू ते किते तेरे गुलाम दा जवाब नहीं ओ तेरियां ते सिफतां दा कोई भी हिसाब नहीं ओ तू ते किते तेरे गुलाम दा जवाब नहीं ओ हुरा नू तू रूप वंडे हुरा नू तू और रूप वंडे हबशी बिलाल दा मैं लब के ले आवां कितों सोना तेरे नाल दा दुनिया ते आया कोई तेरी ना मिसाल दा शान निराली तेरी जात ਅੱਜ ਉਹ ਜੇ ਦੀ ਖਾਲੀ ਸ਼ਾਨ ਨਿਰਾਲੀ ਤੇਰੀ ਜ਼ਾਤ ਤੇਰੀ ਆਲੀ ਬਰ ਦੇ ਤੂੰ ਜੋਲੀ ਅੱਜ ਉਹ ਜੇ ਦੀ ਖਾਲੀ ਮੰਗਤਾ ਨਿਆਜ਼ੀ ਤੇਰੇ ਤੂੰ ਸਦਕਾ ਤੇਰੀ ਆਲ ਦਾ ਮੰਗਤਾ ਨਿਆਜ਼ੀ ਤੇਰੇ ਤੂੰ ਉਹ ਸਦਕਾ ਤੇਰੀ ਆਲ ਦਾ ਮੈਂ ਲੱਭ ਕੇ ਲਿਆਵਾਂ ਕਿੱਥੋਂ ਸੋਹਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਨਾਲ ਦਾ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਤੇ ਆਇਆ ਕੋਈ ਤੇਰੇ ਨਾ ਮਿਸਾਲ ਦਾ ਕੌਣ ਆਇਆ ਤੇ ਕੌਣ ਆਇਆ ਅੱਜ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਆਇਓ ਕੌਣ ਆਇਆ ਅੱਜ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਆਇਓ ਹੋਈਆਂ ਗਲੀ ਗਲੀ ਰੁਸ਼ਨਾਇਆਂ ਉਹ ਇਬਰਾਹੀਮੀ ਉਹ ਗੁਲਸ਼ਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਜ ਅਜਬ ਬਹਾਰਾਂ ਜਿਸ ਨੂੰ ਹਾਸਿਲ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਖਾਤਿਰ ਉਹ ਪਈਆਂ ਮੱਕੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਦੁਹਾਈਆਂ ਉਹ ਸੋਹਣਾ ਲਾਲ ਹਲੀਮਾ ਲੈ ਗਈ ਤੇ ਹੱਥ ਮਲਦੀਆਂ ਉਹ ਰਹਿ ਗਈਆਂ ਦਾਆਂ ਤੇ ਸੋਹਣਾ ਲਾਲ ਹਲੀਮਾ ਲੈ ਗਈ ਤੇ ਹੱਥ ਮਲਦੀਆਂ ਉਹ ਰਹਿ ਗਈਆਂ ਦਾਆਂ
আলহামদুলিল্লাহি রাব্বিল আলামিন ওয়াল আকিবাতু লিল মুত্তাকিন ওয়াস সালাতু ওয়াস সালামু আলা সাইয়্যিদিল আমবিয়া ওয়াল মুরসালিন আম্মা বাদ ফাআউযু বিল্লাহি মিনাশ শাইতানির রাজীম বিসমিল্লাহির রহমানির রহিম ওয়ামা আরসালনাকা ইল্লা রাহমাতাল লিল আলামিন সাদাকাল্লাহুল আযীম اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه میرے نہایت ہی قابل احترام سامعین کرام حاضرین اعزام السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ اللہ رب العالمین کے فضل سے اس کے کرم سے ہم اس کے گھر میں آج کے اس مقدس دن حاضر ہیں. اللہ پاک سے دعا ہے کہ اللہ پاک ہمارے تمام معاملات اپنی رحمت کاملہ کے سپرد فرمائے. اور یہ جو مبارک مہینہ سرکار دو عالم صلی اللہ علیہ وآلہ وسلم کی ولادت کا مہینہ ہمارے درمیان اپنی تمام تر برکات کے ساتھ موجود ہے, ہمیں اس میں زیادہ سے زیادہ سرکار دو عالم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم پر درود شریف پڑھنے کی توفیق عطا فرمائے. اللہ پاک ہمیں ان کی محبت عطا فرمائے. بہت بڑا احسان اللہ پاک نے ہم پر کیا, اور اس سے بڑا کوئی اور احسان ہے ہی نہیں کہ اللہ پاک نے ہمیں ہدایت دینے کے لیے سب سے پیارے رسول صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کو منتخب فرمایا. اس لیے تو ہماری موجیں لگی ہوئی ہیں کہ رسول پاک صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, یہ اللہ پاک کا بہت بڑا تحفہ ہے, بہت بڑا احسان ہے. So, alhamdulillah, we know that this is the first month, just the first Jumu'ah of the blessed month, the new month according to Islamic calendar, which is Rabiul Awwal, the month of the Viladat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. In this month, in this blessed month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He did great ihsan, ihsani azim, upon us, upon the mu'mineen, upon the muslimin, by sending his most beloved and greatest prophet, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, for our guidance. So therefore, I intend to talk about the compassion and the mercy of our beloved prophet, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, and we have not sent you for any other reason. We have not sent you. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا for any other reason. There's only one reason. And that reason is mentioned after the word of istisna, which is illa. Illa rahmatan lil alameen, except absolute mercy and compassion for the whole universe. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came, all anbiya and khatamul mursaleen. Alhamdulillah. Brothers in Islam, so Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is described as an absolute rahma, mutlak rahma for the entire universe. And his quality being merciful, being compassionate, was not just limited to the Muslims, but it also extended to non-Muslims. And some of them, they spent all efforts trying to harm the sacred mission of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is da'wat ila Allah with the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brother in Islam, the mercy of Rasulullah, the forgiveness of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is clearly demonstrated in the fact that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they never took revenge on anyone for personal reason. They never took revenge on anyone for personal reason. And what is the adat sharifa of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? His adat was to forgive others. He showed mercy to others with the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even for his worst enemies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us about some other great qualities of this great messenger by saying in the Holy Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم وبالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. صدق الله العظيم. So Allah says in the Holy Quran that indeed there has certainly come to you a rasul, a messenger, a prophet, min anfusikum, from among yourselves. Azizun alayhi ma anittum. Aziz. It's grievous.
and hurtful to him,
it is
when you suffer. So when we suffer, this is the shan of the rahmat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. When his ummah suffers, when even adna ummati suffers, when we suffer, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gets hurt. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he feels pain when we suffer, when we face calamities. This is the shan of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And Allah says,
Harisun alaykum,
eagerly concerned over us in guidance. Wabil mu'mineena ra'ufur raheem. Ra'ufur raheem. And towards the mu'mineen, the shan of rahmat, alhamdulillah, special shan of rahmat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is for only those who truly believe in Allah and in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bil mu'minina ra'ufur raheem. He is ra'uf. He is the most compassionate and merciful towards those they follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the kind of messenger and prophet we are talking about with the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers, each and every prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came with mercy, with compassion towards their communities, towards their people, towards their people, communities, and nations. So each and every prophet, all of them came with compassion, with mercy, and we do not neglect their compassion and their mercy. We do not neglect the compassion of Nuh alayhi salam. And we know that Nuh alayhi salam had been teaching his nation, had been inviting his nation towards Allah for how long? For almost one whole century. They spent 950 years calling their nation out of their mercy, out of their rahmah. They stayed there and they faced calamities, they faced many challenges. Every new day there was a new challenge, and they used to face all challenges. Why? Out of the rahmah of the ummah. We do not neglect the mercy of Ibrahim alayhi salam. We do not neglect the mercy of Nuh alayhi salam, Daud alayhi salam, Sulaiman alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent all of them. And we know that there is no more merciful than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The most merciful is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. So there is no more merciful than There is no bigger merciful than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send someone who is not merciful towards his makhluk, towards his people? So alhamdulillah, every single prophet, he came with mercy, he came with rahmah. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he brought such rahmah, alhamdulillah, that there is no match, alhamdulillah, for the rahmah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. کوئی مقابلہ ہی نہیں ہے رسول پاک صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کی رحمت کا. Brothers in Islam, very famous and authentic hadith of Rasulullah صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم shed light on his being compassionate and merciful prophet of Allah سبحانہ وتعالی. Rasulullah صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, he used to tell his sahaba kiram, his companions, that I am to you like a person who is trying to turn away, to keep away the flies from burning into a blazing flame. So he tries to protect the flies from falling and from burning in a blazing flame. Why? Because and the flies, they just keep wanting to come and keep throwing themselves to a blazing flame. Why? Flame looks attractive to them. So this is how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they used to teach his companions, they used to teach his sahaba, I am like one who is saving you from flame. And brothers, the temptation of this dunya, the sins of this dunya, they are like a fire.
and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, and they look too attractive, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's saying, I am trying to save you from burning in a blazing flame, because the sins are like a fire. Subhanallah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I am directing you towards great salvation, towards great hidayat with the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they sacrificed his time, his property, his wealth, and even his own sacred blood for our sake, in order to save us. Brother in Islam, we know that the main aim of his struggle, the main purpose of the mission of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is to invite the people to call them towards worshipping one God and to save them from the fire of Jahannam with the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he commanded our great Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to go out of Makkah and spread the message of peace towards those people. Allahu Akbar. Why? Because Allah subhanahu, neither Allah nor his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they want anyone burned into the fire with the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah ordered Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to go outside of Makkah, after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam been calling the people of Makkah towards hidayat, towards truth for many years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them to go outside of Makkah and spread the message. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they decided to go outside of Makkah, and the following incident, historical incident and story, is mentioned in Sahih Bukhari by Muhammad bin Ismail Bukhari rahmatullahi ta'ala. And this very famous and important hadith is narrated by Ummul Mu'mineen Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha. She said, once I asked the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rasulullah, was there any day more difficult to you than the day of the battle of Uhud? And brothers, if you read the history of Islam, if you read the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will find the battle, the day of the battle of Uhud, was a very difficult day for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he suffered a lot. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he wounded. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he injured, and blood was coming from the blessed face of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. His teeth were dislodged, brother, and even an arrow came and hit the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and hurt Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they lost their consciousness and fainted. And the mushrikeen and the enemies of Islam, they spread this rumor, this news, that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they have left this dunya, they passed away. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the most beloved uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Hazrat Hamza, his title is Sayyidul Shuhada. He was brutally murdered and killed in the same battle. And then his body was mutilated by his enemy. Then the day of the battle of Uhud. And that was the most difficult point of my life. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he himself is narrating this to his wife, his beloved wife, Ummul Mu'mineen, Hazrat Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha. So this day of Taif had a very profound impact on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Brothers, when you read the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after the death of two people most beloved to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first, his uncle Abu Talib, his beloved uncle, he used to love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He loved Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he used to protect Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he used to protect against the oppression, persecution and zulm and torture and violence of the people of Makkah, who were the enemies of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And through his position in Quraysh, he diverted much harm from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And after a couple of weeks, the death of his most beloved wife, Hazrat Khatiyat al-Kubra radiyallahu ta'ala anha, who had been by the side of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam throughout his mission as a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
sabra rahi, shakra rahi, khadi rahi, diwar bankar khadi rahi, Rasool Pak sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. To ye do bahut bade jo almiye the, bahut bade sanehe the, ye ek saal mein hi ho gaye Rasool Pak sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. And brothers, the emotional impact on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so severe that this year is known as Amul Huzn, the year of sadness, the year of sorrow. Allahu Akbar Kabira. And if these two incidents were not enough, the same year, a third incident occurred, which is known as the incident of Taif. So brothers, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they left Makkatul Mukarramah for Taif with his one freed slave. And whom Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bought, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam freed him. And this is the common practice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they ordered and advised his companion to do the same, to buy the slave and then free them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they went to the town of Taif with Hazrat Zaid bin Harsa radiyallahu ta'ala an. When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam reached there, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked to meet the chiefs, the leaders of the town, the Taif. And the chiefs of Taif, they agreed to meet with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam because they didn't know why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted to meet them. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he introduced himself as a Rasul of Allah, as a Prophet of Allah, as a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they told them about Islam, about truth, and they told them about worshipping one God, and told them about leaving idol worshipping. So brothers, they humiliated and insulted our great Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the worst possible manner. Allahu Akbar Kabira. So one of them scorned the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, "Away from me. You have gone mad, astaghfirullah. And if you are a prophet, then I might as well destroy the Kaaba." Meaning, what is the point of Kaaba? What is the point of Prophet? Astaghfirullah. The other said, "Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not find anyone better than you to send? So you are the one He has chosen." Astaghfirullah. And the third one said, "If you are a prophet, then you are too holy for me to talk. You are too holy for me to speak with. And if you are not a prophet," meaning if you are a liar, astaghfirullah, "then you are too ignoble and unworthy and unholy for me to speak with." So meaning, either way, you are somebody I cannot speak with, astaghfirullah. And that was the knot, the end of it, brothers. They commanded their slaves, their youth, even their women, to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to ridicule Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to hurt him physically by throwing stones at him, by pelting him as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was leaving the city. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was forced to leave the city. While the people of the city was throwing stones at Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as much as the blood began pour from his body and his shoes became soaked with his own blood. These are the sufferings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he himself narrated to Aisha Siddiqah radhiyallahu ta'ala anha that I couldn't remember where I was going. So this was the state of the shock of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that they didn't know where to go until Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they reached a garden, they entered the garden and they took refuge in the garden. Allahu Akbar Kabila. Then the people, they had stopped chasing our great messenger Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rasulullah sat under a tree, tired, bleeding, being tortured, being humiliated by his own community, by his own ummah. And then Rasulullah, they made dua. And inshallah, I don't have time to share you the Arabic words of dua. But Rasulullah, they made this beautiful dua. And the dua of Rasulullah was responded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself narrated that I saw a cloud hovering above.
And lo and behold, Jibreel al-Islam, they came down. And with Jibreel al-Islam, there was another angel I had never seen before. Jibreel al-Islam said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has seen how your people have responded to you. And your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has heard what your people said to you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent me with the malak, with the angel of mountain. Hukam kya hua? Jo aap kehenge, ye karega. Agar hum is jagah pe hote, तो हम यकीनन कुछ ना कुछ तो रिवेंज मांग रहे हैं, कुछ ना कुछ तो बदला लेते, कुछ ना कुछ तो हम चाहते हैं कि इनके साथ सलूक किया जाए. But this is the perfect misal of the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is why this is one of the greatest favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose us to be the ummah of this greatest prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Rasulullah was still bleeding. His shoes were still wet with his own blood. And Malak is waiting for his words, for his hukam, for his commandment. Ya Rasulullah, if you want, command me, and I will cause the two mountains of Taif to collapse upon them and to crush them. Allahu Akbar Kabira. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, out of the mercy, divine mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they raised their hands and they said, Ya Allah, give hidayah to my people, because they don't understand, they don't know. And they said, Allah will bless their children to be Muslim and to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Although they have rejected me, but I am hopeful their children, they will come and they will take the message and they will practice Islam and they will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they will recognize me and they will recognize and they will consider my highest status which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent me with. So, wo aakar ye kaam karenge. To aapne dua ke liye haath uthaye aur behtri ki dua ki. Hum unke ummati hain jinhe Allah pak ne rahmatul lil alamin banaya aur ye title